Hey, what's up, my ninja? Shinobi here, with an update video for you guys. I haven't done something like this in a while. I think it's been probably about a month or a month and a half, something like that. I like to do these every once in a while, at least one a month, just to let you know what's going on with the channel, maybe some new changes or something, because you subscribe to the YouTube channel, you want to know what's in store, what's coming in the future, where certain type of videos are that you want to see, all that kind of stuff. And the kitty is freaking out in the background there. She's just doing backflips like crazy right now. Yeah. Anyway, you also notice that I'm not wearing a headset right now. Before in the past, what I did is I had a headset with a mic on it. I used the Razer Gregarious. You guys have asked me before, what kind of headset is that? Great headset. I love using it, but the mic is just not the best quality. Ellie, my girlfriend, which is right behind me right now, I believe playing World of Warcraft, she decided to get me an early Christmas present because she's leaving very soon to go see her family for Christmas. So she got me this microphone right here, which is a it's a Blue Yeti mic. That's a USB mic, just higher quality. I hope it sounds really good for you guys in this video. Definitely an awesome gift. She also got me this right here. Check it out. Use the Force. It's got Yoda on there. And you can't see the lightsaber, but when you put something warm in here, it will actually light the lightsaber up. It actually looks really cool. But yeah, I already drank the tea that was in there, so that's all that for right now. But in the future, maybe you guys will be able to see it because I'll be using this cup a lot. And yeah, and so that's the new mic. That's one of the new changes that's happened to the channel here. As far as Reaper of Souls goes, people have been asking me, "Hey, how come you haven't gotten to Reaper of Souls yet? What's going on with that? Have you heard anything?" And trust me, I've been trying to contact as many people as I can, get as many connections as I can to see if I could get into Reaper of Souls quicker. Because I mean, let's face it, you guys want to see some Reaper of Souls gameplay, and I want to get into it. I want to test it. I want to help it help. If I can even help, just a small amount in helping the game become as great as we all know its potential is, then I would be super stoked to do that. Because I feel like with Diablo 3, I don't think it went through like a rigorous testing phase where there were still a lot of things wrong with it when the game came out. And I feel like, with Reaper of Souls, it needs to be really polished before it comes out. And I wouldn't even really mind waiting a couple more months for it to come out, a couple months longer to make sure the game is exactly the way we want it to be. There's a lot of things that so far haven't been implemented in Reaper of Souls that, the developers keep saying maybe you might see it, like ladders or PvP type stuff, but hopefully that'll be coming out soon, and we could actually see more of that, because the game definitely needs an end game right now. From all the stuff that I've been seeing, it looks like a very fun game. It's sad to say that it looks like a fun game. I wish I could say it is a fun game, but I haven't been able to test it. But yeah, and so what am I doing right now for Diablo 3? Well, I am still putting out Diablo 3 videos. You guys have seen, if you haven't been looking up, I put a lot of BlizzCon stuff up. You can check out that. All the playlist stuff will be down below. All the newest stuff that I put out for Diablo 3, you can go check out that stuff. And also, I came up with a really good idea. In the beginning of my YouTube channel, when Diablo 3 first came out, and my channel was much smaller, but still a decent size, what I did is I wanted to help out the subscribers on the YouTube channel. And you guys know when I do like a gear build thing, I pick one of you guys and I build a gear set for you, give it to you on the stream, stuff like that. But I had an even better idea. What I would do is have kind of a preparing for a Reaper of Souls type thing where I play with you. So what I'm gonna do is, if you want to play with me and be in a YouTube video, I'm gonna be have like, I don't know, it's gonna be a 20, 30 minute long video, something like that. I'm gonna be picking three people from each one of the videos. So for instance, in this video, you gotta be subscribed, leave a comment down below, tell me your battle tag. I'm picking only US people right now. We'll do EU later on, but US people for right now. I do have characters on both sides over there. So Just leave your battle tag. Tell me why you'd like to play with me, what you need help with. Do you need gear checks? Do you need more items? And the people that I bring along, I'm going to give them a gear check. I'm going to help get some items for them that they need. And you're going to farm with me for a couple hours or whatever and talk with me over voice communication. It's just a way for me to get in touch with my viewers and also help them out and get them more prepared for Reaper of Souls. So, if right now maybe one of your classes is a little lacking and you need some better gear, so that way you can, have a really good jump and a good start on the expansion when it comes out. Because, I mean, as soon as you enter the expansion, I mean, you're gonna be level 60, and monsters are gonna be a lot more difficult to deal with right off the bat. Especially if your gear is underpowered right now, and you need to actually have gear in order to find gear. It's not like you just join the game and they just hand you a bunch of items. You actually have to have gear first to do that. So that's what I feel like I should do to help you guys out, because we haven't done that in a long time. And so if you want to be added into that, just down below, tell me why you'd like to be part of it. And then when I post the video up, you'll be in a YouTube video and all this kind of stuff. And then I'll show our farming session, what we did, so players can learn from what we did to help better their gear and everything like that. And then I'll pick three new people in the next one. So if that's something you're interested in, just put that down below. And so the main things that I need: you gotta be subscribed, you gotta be part of the Ninja Army, that's just obvious. Leave a comment. So the comment could be with your battle tag, why you'd like to be a part of it, what you might need help with or something like that, or if it's a gear check or you need items or something. And then the last thing, you don't have to like the video. You can do that. It helps out the channel. But, I mean, because I guess it would give you extra brownie points, make you look a little bit better, but it's not a requirement. And then the next topic that I wanted to talk about, and this is kind of like one of those moments where you just feel like you got totally duped or totally trolled, like IRL. So, a little while ago, I think it was back in July, my brother had gotten a cat, and he found out that he couldn't keep the cat. So before it would have to go to one of the shelters and then probably eventually put down, we said, we'll take the cat. Give the cat to us. It's kind of like saving the animal, and we've been wanting a cat for a little while, and so we got one. And I showed you guys in the video a while ago when we got the cat, and you actually helped us pick the name for the cat, and it's actually grown a lot more since then. We picked the name Natalia. You guys helped us choose it. But the other day, the cat was on the bed and just sitting there and cleaning itself, and then Ellie, my girlfriend, which is right behind me right now, looks over and goes, "Oh, that's weird." And I said, "What?" And she says, "Our cat's not a girl." And I'm like, "What are you talking about?" And she's like, "She has a thing." And I'm like, "What? No way." When we got the cat, my brother told me that it was a girl. It's really difficult to tell when they're just like kittens, but everybody told us that it was a girl. And it's not like I just sit there and stare at its junk all the time or whatever. So, yeah, we've had the cat for about 5 months now, and just the other day we found out it's actually a boy. So I think we got pretty much owned IRL there. And I was just like, I was actually in denial for like the first week. I was like, how could this happen? Like, I've been calling it a she all the time, and I even still do it. I'm like, "Oh yeah, she's just playing right now." I mean, he, oh God. So here, I'll show you the cat actually. Ellie has the cat right here. Here he is, not she is. He's, damn it, a lot bigger now. Yes, you are. You're a lot bigger. Yeah. And I'm not actually going to show you the proof or anything like that, but yeah. Definitely a big kitty now. And definitely a boy. So, with that said, I feel weird changing its name, but we need a new name, guys. We need a boy cat's name, preferably maybe something Diablo themed or something like that. Maybe we'll just call the cat Trollolololol. I don't know. I mean, come on, troll, come here. Like, I don't know, man. That's just crazy. But yeah, that's what happened. And yeah, these things happen, I suppose. You'd be surprised, like when I talk to the vet, because we're, thinking about taking him to the vet pretty soon to get shots and all the kind of normal stuff that you need to get and everything like that. And I talked to the vet. I said, "How common is this that people mess this up?" And she said, "Actually, it's really common. Like, it happens a lot." And I'm like, "Wow." And I feel like I'm the type of person where I pay a lot of attention to stuff. I have a really good attention to detail. It's just that's how I've been my whole life. And yeah, but like I said, it's not like I go around staring at the cat's private areas. But yeah, so that's the funny situation there. The last bit of information I want to talk about is on YouTube. There's some YouTube changes going on, and they're very frustrating right now. I've been talking to my network about it. You guys know, or some of you might know, that I'm with the network Polaris, aka the Game Station. We have people like PewDiePie, Wow Crendor, Total Biscuit, the Yogscast, really big YouTubers. It's a really exclusive network to get in, so I've been really happy with getting into that, and they've been helping me out with a lot of situations, and they're even trying to get me into Reaper of Souls, trying to pull any strings that they can too. And if they can't do it, then you know the invites are very limited. So, but the YouTube changes in the beginning of YouTube, when you first start off with YouTube, if like maybe you're starting your own YouTube account, you. When you put a video up, it has to go through like a process where they verify to make sure that it's a legitimate video, there's no copyright, blah 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 blah, and then they give you the okay, and then they set it through, and you can monetize the video. And you guys know that I'm a full-time YouTuber, so I get paid from the ads that are running on the videos, and they help, with going paying the bills and such and stuff like that. And I mean, with all the ad block stuff that's out there and, all the stuff, I mean, it's not a lot of money. It's just enough to get by, trust me. But, and with this new change that they're doing here, and it seems like every time YouTube implements a change, it just hurts the creators and hurts the viewers even more. And this time, that's definitely the case, because they're going back to the old method that they used to use, where, like, for me right now, I can put a YouTube video up and automatically monetize because I'm in a big network, and I have that kind of that perk, I guess you can say it is. But they're pretty much taking that perk away from everybody, and they look at your videos when it goes up, and they have to like get someone to check it. I mean, seriously, there are hundreds of thousands of videos that get put up on YouTube like per day, like probably not hundreds of thousands, probably thousands of videos per day, but like millions per year. They're not gonna have time to watch every one of these videos. So what I've been talking to the network with is they said that the way it's going to work is they're going to, randomly pick people. So like, say my channel gets randomly picked, and then I put up a video that can sit in monetization review for 1 to 3 days. So let's say something exciting happens, Reaper of Souls, they announce PvP, and oh my god, it's exciting, and blah 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 blah. I go to post the video up, and it sits in queue. So it may take up to 3 days to put those videos out. So I feel like this is a really bad thing to be doing. I think if you're already in a pretty big network to begin with, you've already gone through all the scrutiny. Like, networks do background checks to make sure you don't have any copyrighted material. I mean, that's what they do. I think because we've already gone through all that, we shouldn't be dealing with this. I mean, we need to put videos out for our viewers. Our viewers want videos out now. They don't want to wait 2, 3 days. So, but in some cases, it may be instant. So we'll see how it pans out. I don't know exactly how they're going to do this. I personally think that it's just YouTube trying to scare people into not putting up copyrighted stuff, because they're like, oh, they're actually going to look to see if it's copyrighted. Oh my God, I'm not going to do it. I don't do any copyrighted stuff like that. Like, I played Diablo 3, I've played World of Warcraft in the past. Blizzard gives full allowance to partners on YouTube to upload their game footage and, use their logos and use all their stuff that they need to, sounds from the games. That's all I do on my channel. Anytime I put music in my videos, what happens is you have to have music that's allowed to you. So there's certain music companies that said, yes, you can use our music, and they gave me written permission, and they sent that off to me. And yeah, so I have rights to be able to do that stuff. You have to be legitimate if you really want to, make it in this YouTube thing. So, I think that This is more of just an annoying change than anything. It's not like all my videos are gonna be taken down, guys. I mean, don't worry about that. My stuff's not doesn't have copyright on it. Everything's legitimate. It's just the stuff in the future may take some time to be put up. So if you wanted to support the channel more, and you know, you feel for me in this situation of putting out this stuff, I mean, you can always just go watch all my videos. You can just That's all you have to do. If you want to support the channel, just keep watching the videos. Come back, check every day for new videos. And yeah, that's all you have to do. And that's pretty much it. So you can also follow my Facebook down below to see new updates on stuff as well too. But I will be putting videos out as often as I can with this whole change thing that's going on. I don't know what's going to happen with it. But you know, they may target me and say, hey, you know, you're going to be sitting in queue for a while, and they may not. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully things don't change that much, but it's kind of unfortunate that YouTube is really pushing us towards this type of change. So, anyways, this has been kind of a little bit longer vlog video, but I had a lot of stuff I wanted to talk about. So remember, if you guys want to be a part of farming with me in Diablo 3, we're doing the US one right now. So I want to see all your comments down below, and I'll pick three people, and you'll be in the next YouTube video. Yeah, that's about it. So I've been reading over the Reaper of Souls stuff. And I'm really excited to get into it, but it should be very soon. If I don't get into it, like in the next few days, the closed beta was in was is in with like a week or two from now. So yeah, everything should be pretty good there. But yeah, anyways, thanks for checking out the video, guys. Hitting the subscribe, the thumbs up, and all that good stuff. And see you in the next video. I'm Shinobi, and thanks for watching.